This is Catherine Roseland here with Oregon Gate TV at Expo 2014. I'm sitting here with Gary Dickin from Lionel Brothers, and he's here to talk about the new game Steam Donkey.
Well, Steam Donkey's only 6 weeks old, so it's still a baby, really.
Oh, wow.
It's a fast-playing game for 2 to 4 players. Two players about 30 minutes, 3 or 4 players add another 15, 20 minutes tops. You can only do one thing per turn, which is the key, which is why it's fast.
Okay.
The object is to build your seaside resort, a typical British seaside resort, just 12 spaces in it, and the first person to finish their 12th spot stops the game. Everybody else gets one more turn, and then we add up, see who's got the most valuable and prestigious seaside resort.
So seaside resorts, I like it.
Mm-hmm. The actions are, you get dealt 8 cards to start with. The actions are to build in your resort, or to take visitors to your resort, or to take the visitors back into your hand. If for some reason you can't do any of those, occasionally that might happen, you can always take the top discard into your hand directly. So with a typical hand, the mechanism is that you've got to use the same types of cards to build that card. So this is a transport card in the green area, which is the park area, and I need to have 2 other transport cards, which I just happen to have, to discard onto the discard pile in order to build that. And then I've built that in my green park area. You're gonna have a green park area, a red town area, and a yellow beach area. So you'll have 3 layers.
Okay.
In each layer, you'll have amusements with donkeys, you'll have transport, you'll have accommodation like that, and you'll also have monuments like that. So there's 4 types in 3 layers, a 12 space grid.
Mm-hmm.
In my green area, since I'm building, I could also build something else in the green area, because normally you can only build in one area at a time. I could build this donkey amusement by throwing away another donkey card.
Yeah.
If I'd chosen to start in the yellow area, I could have built this for nothing because there's no icon in the corner.
Yeah.
The points value is in the bottom right, and the number of visitors that can be attracted to it is the number of card icons in the top right.
So this brings a lot of people but doesn't give you anything.
That's right. You could overbuild that later in the game though in order to score. So I would build that straight away because it's good to have the transport and another one. I can't build anything else. Well, actually, I could if I was allowed to build in 2 areas, but that's available in the advanced game, not the basic game.
Yeah.
The advanced game, we use these cards. So that would be my turnover. So everybody else would have a go, come back to me. Now I can't, say imagine I can't build, I'm going to take visitors to my resort. Green visitors go to the green area, so I could take that one and that one. But I might want to take that one because that can go anywhere. And it's usually, it's called a special card, and it's usually a higher value card on the other side. You know that you can't see what's on the other side. You'll know that, for instance, this wants to go to the yellow area, and it's going to be a transport card, but you don't know necessarily this one happens to be a yellow area. It might not be.
Yeah.
So sometimes there's a bit of misinformation. However, I do that. That's the maximum that I can take to that card. But the transport allows me to take one straight to my hand.
Oh.
The special, because it's +1 card. So because I'm looking for accommodation, I'm going to take, well, there isn't an accommodation. So next best thing maybe is to take a donkey. So I'm going to take a donkey. And then this gets filled up again at the end of my turn. There's always 4 cards available, plus the top of the pack. And that's my go over. Goes round again. Comes back to me. I now want to take these visitors into my hand, so I've got more cards to play with. That's my go, so everybody can start doing theirs now. So you can see that it goes quite quick.
Yeah, so you're basically, you're building attractions, you're trying to get the visitors, and then you get the revenue or whatnot from your visitors, which you then can build new buildings.
Then I can now build more.
Mm-hmm.
So I've now got the ability to build in the red area. So I could build a donkey in the red area by throwing away that donkey. And now I've got the ability to attract visitors to the red area as well. In the advanced game, there's a card that allows you to take visitors to 2 areas rather than 1.
So you have to choose one area or another area.
In the basic game.
You can't choose 2 areas.
Yeah.
But once, if you choose one area, you can get everything in that area.
Oh, yes. Yeah. And if you take visitors up, you can take all the visitors. Doesn't matter which area they're in. That's the basic game. And it goes around until somebody's finished their resort. And then everybody has one last go. And then we see who's got the most
points.
In the advanced rule, you are dealt one of the typical British seaside resorts, Brighton Esports, Skegness, Blackpool. They've got different objectives, and they also carry bonuses. So with Brighton, you don't have to fill 12 spaces, you just have to fill 10. And you get 3 points bonus for each monument in your resort. So that will give you a bit of focus for your play.
And it's also giving a little variation between the players, so each person's focus is different.
That's right. So you get that, and you also get dealt one of these cards at the start. This will stay with you through the game. One allows you to hold up to 15 cards in your hand, because normally the maximum is 12. One allows you to start the game with 12 cards rather than 8, which is a racing sort of start, which is a one-off benefit. Whereas these are continuous benefits. The mechanical dog allows you to draw 3 more visitors into the railway station, so you've got a bigger choice of visitors for your turn. And the feral donkey allows one donkey card to be used as a wild card, so it could be a monument or a transport. So that's quite nice. They stay with you throughout the game. However, you also get whatever is on the opposite.
So you're getting something positive, but you're also getting a negative,
No, not a negative. Usually something positive. So on the back of the feral donkey, you would start with Donkey Boy. And there's always work for Donkey Boy. Because he allows you, whatever you're doing, to always take the top discard into your hand. Madam Ice Cream allows you to choose 2 areas to bring visitors to instead of 1. And the Lord Admiral allows you to build in 2 areas instead of 1. And the delicious Princess Royal allows you to build for 1 card less, because she has lots of influence.
So everyone's getting a few extra advantages.
Yeah. And when you use them, you turn them, so it's used. When it comes back to you, she comes back up again.
Okay.
If I don't use her, because maybe I'm taking visitors and not building, she's available for swap. So one of the other players could swap one of theirs with her to be able to use it.
Oh, and so they actually
so these will move around amongst the players.
Oh, interesting.
So it adds quite another layer of of sort of infighting and strategy.
It has this lovely steampunky theme to it.
Yeah, I mean, we're very pleased with the artwork. Our man in Brazil, Marco, did the artwork for us. And yeah, we're very pleased. It's going very well.
Fantastic.
That's it in a nutshell.
That sounds like
a lot of fun. Fun game.
Great, thank you so much. That is Steam Donkey from Rainline Games. Rainline Brothers.